Family Magical says, how are you doing? If it's the first time that you find me, remember there are never coincidences. I am Ori Miriam. I work with spirits, with the spirit world since I was very young and in my past life as well. And I have been a healer in many healer psychic medium. So I feel blessed that you're here. Let's see, guys, about magical souls, about your future spouse, because it's been quite long since I haven't done a reading about future spouse. And I know many of you, you're thinking about, yes, that special and magical person that maybe you already know or you're going to know in the future. Remember to subscribe and touch the notification bell if you resonate with my energy and if you want to support my channel. Another way of supporting my channel, you know, guys, donations, thank you. And I have just started new services. I'm going to do different type of services, of stuff with different prices, so I can help as many people as possible, but I have to take care of my energy as well. So my lovelies, remember you can follow me on Instagram as well with the same name and in my Spanish channels if you want to listen to me talking in Spanish. So my lovelies, I'm going to do it this time differently. You know, many of you know that I'm Aquarius, we like to try new things. So nevertheless, this is group number 1, 2, 3, and 4, yes? But I'm going to shuffle these images, so this way it's going to help you guys to choose. So, I sense this one wants to be in group number 1. Okay, guys, this is 1. Angels, group 2. They're telling me to take this one. Okay, the clock. They're telling me to get this one for 3. Beautiful. And the fourth one, this one. Very interesting. So remember, this is a general reading. Only take those messages that resonates and enjoy the reading. I want you guys to enjoy and to receive messages from your loved ones. That's why all of my work. Okay, my lovelies? So let's get started. Beautiful magical souls.
You say, take me on a treasure hunt. I long for something new. Have you heard the fairies when they sing and dance? Oh, I wish it was me.
My lovelies, group number 1. Wow, I am getting more and more amazed about the information that it's coming through whenever I'm doing a new reading. Okay, why am I telling you this? Okay, I see very clearly group number 1. Before I get into the cards and I do the channeling, well, I'm already doing the channeling, but the spirits are telling me that your future spouse is somebody new. That's why I started talking about something new. This is somebody new, but coming from past lives. Okay, this is the first cards that you saw in the introduction. They are Doreen Virtue's past lives, Brian Weiss. I'm not sure if it's Brian Weiss or Doreen Virtue. I think it's both of them that they worked in these cards. And this is monk or nun. So what I see between the monk and the nun card, the energy work, and the rest of the cards, I want to tell you many stuff. I'm going to focus. I'm getting excited. Okay, my love, let's go step by step. Okay, so you chose this cassette, this old cassette. Well, for me, it's the meaning that your future spouse is somebody older than you. Okay, loves, because this is the typical cassette that I used when I was younger, because I am more than 40 years old, and this, if some of you, maybe you remember, guys, and if you're a millennium, or maybe you're not a millennium, but you're a little bit older, but for us that We were born in the 70s, 60s. This was very typical back in time. So for sure, this person, it doesn't mean that they are more than 40 years old, because I know it's many of you with different range of ages. But it is true that I see with this sign from spirits that this is somebody that it's working on their passion. This I see in other cards as well, but they're passionate and they're working on the passion, and it's older than you. Okay, loves? This I see very clearly. Where do I see in more cards that this person is working on the passion? With the card, follow your heart. Look at that. Again, another heart. And isn't this incredible? I reorganized the cards because first I was thinking, I don't like it like that. I'm going to change this card with this one so you guys, you see it better. But it makes sense why I did that. Look at this. Synchronicity. It's like two towers. So incredible. It's like very similar, the hands, the way, like a tower. And look at this woman. She's like a tower as well. Even it could seem like a hangman for me. It's very similar to that card of the old tarot. Yes, follow your heart. This person for sure, it's somebody that follows their heart. What does that mean? That this person calibrates, works, their base is coming from their heart, from the heart chakra. This is somebody that it may appear because they're doing so well at work, okay? I sense that whether you're a student or not, your future spouse is already working, whether some of them they're students, but they're working. They're working in the passion. They have been working in the passion for quite a long time. Whether you're very young or you're older, your future spouse has been working on the passion and has been like a sort of alchemist coursing in the passion. They have mastered their passion. Some of them could be healers, because I see here, this is telling me the monk and the nun. This is somebody from past lives that has always been very connected, like you. Come on, both of you guys, you have found each other in many of your past lives. And if you're going to marry him or her again, your future spouses, because both of you guys, you have been together, maybe not married in all of their lives, because if one past life, you were a nun and he was a monk, or the other way around, or both of you were nuns, or both of you were monks, but you had that connection in that past life. I think that this past life was the origin of your true love life. And because when, you know, guys, in old time, in the ancient times, right now, concerning some type of religions, I know that, for example, in USA, many priests marry and they have children. But back in times, it was not like that. And it was seen as a sin to be with somebody from your own sex, or somebody, imagine, working for God, when their energy was supposed just to be focused in God. But both of you, you found each other in that past life. Why? Because both of you, you wanted to experience how to experience a great, intense love without touching each other, and only touching, not only, but you know what I mean, guys, touching each other's heart and flowing through emotions and enjoying the process. It could also seem like a platonic love story, but it wasn't, because both of you, you saw each other every day and you talked to each other, maybe even just by through your eyes, because I see both of you in that past life. Let me know in the comments, guys, does it make sense? But spirits are showing me both of you. Remember, it's many of you, this is a general rhythm, so many, maybe, remember, maybe you were a nun and you were in love with another nun, or maybe both of you, you were monks, or maybe you were a nun and he was a monk, okay? But I see the situation, this very long table, you know, guys, eating all of them, quiet, maybe praying, a little pray before they eat, and not talking, or not talking a lot. And I see both of you looking at each other constantly, trying to be discreet, okay? Because I think that more and more other people, other nuns and monks, were aware about that intensity between both of you. Both of you, you have always mastered energy. Both of you, you have been healers. Both of you, you have been working in religion or in spiritual matters. You, both of you, you're masters of energy, of healing, of praying, of being connected to the source, of being connected to God, being connected always, always, always with the source and with one and another. This person, your future spouse that you are attracting, is somebody that, I don't know right now, but for sure when they were young, or maybe they're still very young, because remember, it's many of you, different ages, they had very long, long hair. Long hair, very balanced, very intuitive, very connected to the source, and very open to receive messages. That's why it makes sense. People that are working on the passion, and they are evolving, they are transforming themselves. They are pure alchemists, walking alchemists, instead of walking dead, walking alchemists. And they receive the messages perfectly, and they flow with their heart, the passion, and they are ready for any kind of obstacle. Why the heart? This is incredible. Oh my gosh, I need more time for the reading. This heart, it's besides this heart of the other, let me put this here, I'm getting excited already, I hope you too. This heart is besides this one. I didn't do it on purpose, because when I'm shuffling and I'm connecting with source and angels and spirits, I'm not looking into details. Then I realize many stuff, but look, this big heart between two orders. You're never alone. Again, this person is ready to flow through the emotions, through the passion, through the heart, and they have this umbrella closed just in case it rains. Nevertheless, if it rains, they're going to still flowing and surfing and enjoying the process. This is enjoying. This heart is enjoying. It's flowing. And what are the otters? The animal totem of the otter, it's an animal totem that likes, that are very tender, they're very familiar as well, okay, guys? They're very familiar. And they're very playful. I see here playfulness. I see here playfulness. He or she's never going to, and this is very important. This is a very important message that the spirits are telling me, group number one. Your future spouse is never, 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 whether they're physically with you or not, because both of you, you're going to have your lives. You will work on your passion as well, probably. And not you, both of you, you're not going to be together 24 hours, but whether physically or not, you're going to be together less or more hours. You're never going to feel alone with this future spouse, with this relationship. Why? Because this connection, it's another level. Whenever I see so many hearts and so many playfulness, this is another card telling me, with play, have fun, celebrate, don't be so serious. Three cards of playfulness. Three, which is the number of the masters. Both of you, you're masters. Both of you, you're going to, if you, let me tell you guys, because you know that if I'm watching more stuff, and this is celebration as well, okay? And this, and she reminds me of Cleopatra and of Isis and Nefertiti. So Egypt, probably it's one important past life. And it's very curious because I was doing my meditation before and I saw myself in my past life in Egypt. So it makes sense that I'm remembering my meditation with you guys. This connection comes from Egypt, back in times. And if it appears, the number three, it's masters. Why? Because both of you, you're masters of energy, of flowing from your heart and enjoying in the process. Why? Because both of you, you're starseeds. I know some of you, maybe this is the first time you hear about, you listen about starseeds. Just flow. Let the universe tell you more stuff about you and the future spouse that you're just about to meet. I am listening from spirits. And masters are preparing this connection again. They have always approved out of this love relationship. Why? Because both of you, you're so good with your heart and your energy that you make a perfect team together. Not only as lovers. Yes, of course, I see passion because I see a lot of red. And I see a lot of playfulness. Even in sex, you're going to have a lot of fun. I see both of you laughing, laughing, laughing. And one of the two is saying, okay, if we continue like this, we're not going to make love. I mean, in a funny way. You know, guys, that sense of energy, like, whoa. And look at this. Two of Pentacles. Come on. One of the best cards for love. For a loving relationship. Both of you on the same level. Both of you creating a butterfly between, look at the skulls. This is such a beautiful picture. And holding hands. And suddenly the spirits are telling me that they are holding one of the two. I think that your future spouse is holding your heart. I don't see a heart here, but through my third eye, the spirits are showing me a heart. So this person, your future spouse, is going to take care of you. Both of you, you're a beautiful big butterfly together. You're a beautiful transformation, making sense. Both of you, you make sense. How can I explain it in English? Both of you, you give identity to the, yes, to the word of love, of a loving relationship, of a healthy relationship, of a relationship that knows how energy works, of a relationship that knows how to have fun and enjoy. And being, I see both of you very, very comfortable together. Suddenly the spirits are showing me this. They're telling me to get this one. This could be the letters of the surname or the name AGFA Ferro. Ferro, it could even be a surname of a grandfather or maybe of your future spouse. And this person is going to bring you color in your life and passion. This, your future spouse, is going to show you how, when we are aligned, when we are supposed to do what we came here for. Yes, why are we here? Living this human experience. Not only to find the love of our lives, which you will, absolutely, but to find your soul purpose, to enjoy the process, not to be so serious about it, not to stress so much about money, because, and this I tell you guys, because I have been working with manifestations. I sit with myself, because I'm not going to teach anyone through the readings or through my sessions or through private readings or through my videos how to manifest if I'm not seeing the real results. I tell you guys, when we are stressed, and that's why am I telling you this? And because the spirits are telling me, and then it makes sense about the cards that it came out. Finances at work. Your love in life, it's getting through problems, through this moment, of course, related to finances, like your finances. So, spirits are telling you, the way you can manifest sooner and quicker this incredible connection, that it's going to be playful, that it's going to bring you delight, energy, it's going to make you flow. It's going to make you feel that he or she is part of your great blessings since you were born. Always expect the best. This person is going to bring you something so, 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 so incredible good. But spirits are reminding you, don't stress about this connection. And most important, don't stress about money. Try not to, I mean, I know it's easy for me to tell you guys, but I know what it's to be stressed about money. I have passed through the same. But it's true that when I'm online, I'm doing my meditations, I go to nature, and I have started doing earthing. If you want to see the documentary about earthing, it's amazing. How when we take out the shoes and we, and look, she has no shoes, I think she has no shoes, and she's touching the flowers, being in the present moment. So spirits are telling you, don't stress about this connection. It's coming. Have fun. The more you have fun and the more you start to work through your passion, both of you, you will come together. Why these two cards together as well? The spirits are telling me to show you guys. Both of you, you have passed through a tower moment. Both of you, you had to suddenly stop. Stop everything in your life. Everything, if not everything, almost, maybe you lost your job, maybe you lost your home, or maybe your parents divorced and it was very traumatic. Something very hard for both of you happened, but that prepared for both of you to be stronger, to go through this challenge, through these challenges, you're stronger. This is preparing you for your destiny. You're supposed to work like your future spouse in your passion, through your passion. Imrama, where are you being called to journey to? And for me in Imrama, I see Ra, Amon Ra, again, another connection. So Egypt, very important connection between both of you. So this card is telling you, the moment you start your passion, you work through your passion, whether you don't want to live your studies or your current job, but you have to start with your passion, like your future spouse have done. All of that is going to bring you a lighter energy. You're going to feel more connected with your heart. You're going to flow. You're going to at last be able to catch, to get the catch, the best catch for you. This is a bride. This is telling you that, a confirmation that you're going to marry the love of all of your past lives. But stay strong. Don't lose hope. Both of you, you're going to learn to know each other better. So I see both of you making an effort. I don't think that both of you, you guys, you're going to start like a quick sex. No, I don't think so, because of this card and the rest of the cards. I see like a very deep connection. I'm not telling you, this is a general reading, and maybe some of you, you feel that you want to start like that, and you're going to start like that, and it's fine. But in general, I feel that both of you, you're going to know each other like in a more slowly rhythm, because both of you, you need it. Although you're going to go like, whoa, like very fast concerning sex, passion, attraction, chemistry between both. But you're going to stay calm while you're meeting your future spouse, and your future spouse is going to stay calm as well, because both of you, you know yourself very well, and you know that if you lose control, you come again to the memories of the tower moment, okay? But don't worry, this is not going to happen. Wow, I love it. Let me shuffle about personality, the last ones. Abundance and authenticity. Oh my gosh, this is incredible. Ah, I forgot to tell you guys, they're doing very good economically. Sorry, I didn't say thank you, spirits. Wow, this person is working through the passion. They could be, they're somebody authentic. They're working through the passion. They could be writers. They could communicate. They could be speakers. They could motivate. They could help others. Maybe they're coaches or therapists or teachers. Or maybe in their business, because they have the business with something completely different than what you have in your mind, they speak a lot with employers. I think that this person is very generous. I think that they give like a lot of money and helps for their employers. If they have children, if they have any problem with their children or something, they're very generous. Wow, group number one, let me know. I love this connection, really, I love it. If I chose another reading from another tarotist and I received these messages, I would love it. My lovelies, remember to subscribe if you want to support my channel. Thank you. And follow me on Instagram. I would love to see you there. Thank you for the donations. Good for the channel. And I love all of you. Bye.
'Treasure hunt. I long for something new. Have you heard the fairies when they sing and dance? Oh, I wish it was me every night. When I close my eyes, I see.
Welcome, group number two. Wow, all of you guys, or you are natural mediums, or one of your family members that passed away is very good at communicating like a medium, or is a master of communication from the spirit world, because I see so clearly that this connection, your future spouse, it's somebody that maybe some of you, it's your mom or your dad that passed away, or your brother or your sister or a close friend that passed away. Even somebody that really loved you so dearest, or even an ancestor that you never knew, because when you were born, maybe they died when you were very young, but this is for sure an ancestor, because I'm sensing the messages very clearly. Group number two, your ancestor, your loved one that loves you so much. He or she has prepared this connection, this future spouse for you. I have to tell you guys, group number two, because suddenly the spirits are talking to me quite fast. They're telling me that many of you, you think that you already know your future spouse or somebody that you have in your mind, or even an ex is your twin flame or your soulmate or your loved one, or is going to be your future spouse. If you're going to resonate with the energy from now, and everything that I'm going to tell you makes sense to you because you're very intuitive, if you're so connected with spirit world like this, is because you are very sensitive and you're very intuitive. Okay, so this connection has been carefully, I am listening from spirits, prepared for you. Okay, I am listening from many ancestors and many spirits that suddenly they are here or they are communicating with me through this reading. They're telling me that you're somebody very special, very unique. And you need somebody very special too. You cannot be with somebody of the media. You need somebody unique. You need somebody very sensitive, or at least that they understand how emotions works and how does the mind work, habits, mind and reactions. Your future spouse, I believe, it's a master of emotions, of intelligence emotion. He or she is very intelligent concerning their emotions. And you need that. You need it because you couldn't be with somebody that's too mental or is too immature or doesn't know what they want in life. You need somebody that it's very straightforward, somebody that has a sort of power, powerful gifts, I am listening. Maybe you see that this person, for some of you, your future spouse, you see that they're doing amazing with the business. Maybe others, you think, wow, this person is incredible, the way he or she treats me. Many of you, you're going to think like, whoa, I like this ability from this person. But what I see, because of this beautiful, like, magical powder, besides fairies, again, fairies here, and flow like water, if you're not water element, group number two, you're attracting somebody that has water element. It makes sense because I'm sensing a future spouse that it's very, very in touch with their emotions. They know how to handle emotions. But I see like a little bit of earth or and fire element as well. A little bit of air, some of them. But I see more a mix of water and earth, which is a good balance, isn't it? Earth and water. Water, they flow, they know how to flow, but earth, they know how to be grounded, okay? That's why the fairies are touching the trees. They like to touch trees. They're very touchy, okay? They're very touchy, they're going to love to touch you, they're going to love to touch you through intimacy. They're going to love to touch your heart, they're going to love to touch your mind, they're going to love to touch you through many different senses. They're very connected with their senses. They're going to tell you that they can smell like a dog, for example. Very interesting. I've never heard stuff like this in the readings. But it's true. Some people, they have this, a part of, I think that all of us, we have so many abilities. This is a process of evolution and of knowing ourselves better. And your future spouse is still knowing themselves, and they love that. They like to fly. They like to travel. They're going to travel the whole world if it's meant to be with you. They're going to spend a lot of money, which for them, it's nothing. For them, money, it's like, how can I explain? It's like an interchange of energy. It's not like the idea of what we have of money, stress of money, only the people that are rich are bad people. You know, guys, that all of us, and if you're still watching me and if you are following me, you know that we come from those patterns, those beliefs about money, that it's very related to people that are selfish or evil or bad people, which is ridiculous, isn't it? And this person knows about this. And maybe I'm not telling you guys that if you think like that, it's ridiculous. I have passed through the same. Yes. But through time, through the experiences, they have understood that what society is expecting of them to be like, or to flow like, or to show the world like, they don't care at all what the system says, what society says, that if you're 30, if you're 25, you have to be married in one culture and another one. If you're not married in your 40s, you are a loser, or you have to be a mother or a father, otherwise you are not worth it. All those type of patterns and beliefs, they don't care about it. It's not that they don't care that they don't meet you right now. They want to meet you. They're longing to meet you, okay? Both of you guys, you have been trying to manifest each other through a lot of praying and affirmations. I am listening from spirits. And if the first are coming out, planning, patience, cooperation, very, very powerful, this message. Spirits are telling you that do a sort of planification as a vision board, affirmations, meditations for 20 days at least. I am listening from spirits. I don't know if it's 20 or 22. It makes sense because to create a new habit, we have to do something for 20. I believe, let me know in the comments, guys, but I think it's 22 days. But spirits are telling you, create a new planification to manifest this incredible future spouse, because they're doing the same. This is a person that knows how to have a planification every day and to follow every day. Okay, more or less, I wake up at this hour. It's not that they're very strict, but for them, it's very important to be organized. Planification is important for them. I think that they have a Virgo in their chart. Virgo, Aries, could be Taurus as well. Interesting. And patience, cooperation. They understand about life that if they cooperate, if they give the universe, people, love, respect, value, good moments, they're empathic, they listen to people, they put their heart in whatever conversation they're having with people. They know how to connect with people. They know how to connect. I mean, I think that's an important key for both of you guys to live this relationship in its pure and truest essence of love. He or she's going, your future spouse is going to know how to touch the core of your heart. They're going to bring you peacefulness. This person loves peacefulness, and it makes sense because I am watching all of the future spouses of group number two talking with people. Maybe they go to a restaurant and they say, like, maybe it could seem like five words that are simple, but they make the waiter smile. And what does that action do? Maybe that waiter or waitress, this is an example, so you understand the type of future spouse that you're attracting, my loves. Just by making them change the energy in that moment, that because probably some of them, they're worried about the coronavirus, or they're getting fired, or maybe the waitress husband has just lost their job, and just a beautiful, simple action, straightforward, beautiful, coming from the heart, pure energy, pure magical energy, like a fairy. How does fairies work? They flow. They are not acting. They are just being themselves. And they believe in magic. And they believe in great energy. Fairies is very related with high vibration. And that's your future spouse. So your future spouse knows how to change the day or the week of that person that is very worried and has low vibration. They know how to help people, people that are broke have ideas that money is difficult to achieve, or even love difficult to get. They know how to transform poverty to rich, to abundance. They have the key. It's flowing, touching the true core. If they have to get a plane, a flight, to be with the loved one, or to be with his or her loved ones, with their family, because the family needs their attention, a hug, some words, Or maybe because a client, maybe because of the business, they need, maybe they don't want to get a plane, but they know they have to do it. This is somebody that they're not going to do anything that they don't feel like it, but if they think that that it's going to be for the best purpose or the bit of the business, of the life, of the personal life, they're going to do it. What for you could be like a very, wow, big effort and a lot of pressure and you being in the middle and people pointing at you, people putting pressure on you because they want a lot of you. For this person, it's pure fun. It's easy. They flow like this. I was going to say mermaid. Flow like water. Your future spouse knows how to flow like water. What does it mean? That they know how to manage people. Remember, your future spouse is a master of emotions. A master. Complete master of emotional intelligence. And that allows him or her to, if they are losing money, to win money quickly and even the triple. I have to be sincere. I think that both of you guys, and if not so much them, but I think it's both of you, you have passed through a moment of pressure about other people or that the family, maybe your family is pressuring you about time or you feel that time is passing and you're not finding your future spouse. Maybe you want to become a mom or a dad and you're saying, oh my gosh, time is passing. Where are you? Where are you? And they passed with the same. I think that both of you guys, you had to learn how to be patient, how to plan your life, but in a more relaxed way, from flowing, from being authentic. Maybe some of you, you're working in the beauty industry or you're creating a product concerning beauty. Maybe it's a makeup or you're doing makeup tutorials, some of you, or maybe you're preparing, you want to prepare incredible, create incredible stuff for the skin, for men and women so they look better. Maybe you're an influencer, you have been a model or you're a model. And if it's not that, both of you, you're very, very, very beautiful. Very beautiful. People are going to turn around to see both of you guys because the energy is going to be amazing. I sense that some of you, you're struggling with some debts or with some money or you're not happy at work. Maybe if you're a student, you're not very happy about what you're studying and you're afraid of telling your parents. Even some of you, you're working and if you're afraid of telling your family because you don't want, you always have that feeling of you don't want to disappoint people or the people that you love. But spirits are telling you through this reading, you have to be authentic. And he or she had to learn the same. Your future spouse had to learn how to be authentic, how to be patient. Being patient and constant and working yourselves and working in something that you like, it's going to allow you to touch abundance in general. This person feels very abundant. So they transform from feeling a lot of pressure from society and family to just flowing and releasing that fear. And they're going to teach you that as well. Maybe some of you already know about this, and this is just a reminder or a confirmation that you're doing really good, that he or she's close. Wow, Two of Cups. I'm so amazed because the Two of Cups and of authenticity has come out in group number one. Oh my gosh. Beautiful synchronicity. So group number two. This future spouse that you're attracting, he or she is pure authentic. It's going to bring you authentic communication. Words, love. Two of Cups is the best card for me. One of the best cards, like the Sun card. Yes, and the Ace of Pentacles is amazing as well. Two of Cups, great love, great dates. Your animal totem getting very well with his her animal totem. Maybe you have kids and they have kids. Or maybe you have a kid and they have an animal. But really, your family and their family, they're going to get along very well. They are, your family is going to fall in love with your future spouse. They're going to say, oh my gosh. I adore him, I adore her, and I see beautiful sunsets together, a lot of romance, a lot of hours talking and talking and talking. I see elegance. I see like a sort of a mix. I think your future spouse is a mix of, hippie and elegant. Hippie and elegant. I don't know if that style, that style exists, I suppose, if you fit a spouse, but they're different. They dress differently. Why these cards? And it makes sense. Storm Angel. Death. Wow. So both of you, Storm Angel, collision of beliefs, styles, attitudes, and energies, and death. Both of you, you had to struggle a lot in the past about beliefs, system of beliefs that you got from your family, that you're supposed to be married by 35 and already have 2 or 3 children. Yes? That from 8 months in a work, in a new career or job, or 8 years, you should be already a boss. So both of you, you broke at last with all of this. Both of you, you work in the same stuff. In the I think that when you were both of you younger, you were not very patient. And this is something that you have been mastering as well. Dress of alchemy. This is beautiful because I was talking about a master of alchemy in group number one, just in case you were feeling wrong to 1 and 2. Release your power. So this person that you're attracting knows how to be very powerful in the sense of flowing and energy and abundance. I think that they work with clients that the clients have a lot of power. Maybe he or she's a politician or works for politicians or works in the government or is a judge as well, like in the past life. New day transformation. This is a confirmation that this is somebody new. And I believe that both of you guys, you're going to see for the first time when it's during the day or when you're going to start watching dragonflies, even butterflies. If you suddenly get visited by beautiful butterflies or you sense something different with butterflies or dragonflies through readings or through a movie or you dream with dragonflies, this is the sign that you are just about to transform yourself into... I think that you have been working into a new identity like your future spouse. Both of you, you feel different. Both of you, when you're going to find each other, you're going to feel absolutely different. You're going to feel very at peace with yourself. You're not going to be stressed about what your dad or your mom says, what your best friend says, what you see around you. When you're going to be happy, at peace with yourself, and not worrying about anything and just flowing and relaxing and enjoying the present moment and being authentic with yourself and understanding that this is a process of we are here for a life, but then you come from the next life and then you return through another reincarnation. We never die. It's just transformation. It's a new day, new life, death, new life, death, new life, death, new life. So if you understand life like that, you push away a little bit of pressure of what is expected from the 3D dimension society and our dad or mom always told us that love should be like this and your future spouse should be like that. And you're going to break absolutely with everything when you do it with yourself like he or she has done already. I want to shuffle before I end up the reading. Last messages, spirits. They're telling me, guys, that I didn't say that in group number one, but they're telling me in group number two that maybe you're going to meet your future spouse from 3 to 6 months. Happiness. Wow, wow, wow. Perfect. Soulmates. This is absolutely a connection of soulmates. I didn't say it before. I see soulmates here, soulmates. Probably both of you guys, you come from Atlantis. Whenever I see dolphins and water, reminds me of Atlantis. And look at the sun. The sun appears here and the new day. So both of you, you have been transforming yourself so much. And that's why, spirits, your loved one has prepared this incredible connection that absolutely it's coming from Atlantis. Both of you, you're already connected through your psychic, through your dreams. Probably some of you have seen physically this person already, or you know the name already. You have received the message from spirits. Beautiful group number two. Don't worry about timing, okay? Don't try to relax because they are coming to you. Okay, my loves? My beautiful group number two. If you have liked it, give it a like, subscribing and subscribing to my Instagram channel with the same name. And thank you for your support through the donations, for your support, just being here, and your comments, your loving comments. I love all of you guys so much. Bye. Bye. Enjoy. Have a beautiful day. Bye.
You say, take me on a treasure hunt. I long for something new. Have you heard the fairies when they sing and dance? I wish it was me every night. When I close my eyes, I see beauty lives in me.
Welcome, group number 3. Wow. I have not pulling out so many cards with all of you guys because I see very clearly what I have to tell you already. And I felt from spirit that this was fine, perfect. So this is telling me as well that your future spouse is somebody that vibrates from simplicity. Not that he or she is simple, but they are very down to earth, very evolved old souls, very wise old soul. I mean, this we can tell about healer. I think that if not both of you guys, for sure your future spouse in many of the through the past lives, there have been maybe a shaman, medicine man, medicine woman, healer. Even they were very connected with Native Indian Americans, or they were very connected with India. I sense with India, or maybe even with the locals. I know in Spanish is aborígenes, but you don't understand me, guys. The ones from Australia, that they are Indians, but they're different, a little bit different. And what else? And I sense, of course, shamans from South America. So all of you guys, you chose the music sheet. Why? Sorry. Sheet? Why? Because the spirits were telling me that you're just a little bit fed up. I mean, I don't think that you complain, or maybe you have just started to complain about that, or to being aware that you, since you were very young, and that probably is because you passed through situations that you felt danger, that you felt that you had to be there for everyone. Maybe you were 5, 7, 8 years old and your parents were divorcing, or they fought it, or they were struggling with money or with life in general. You felt that you always had to be there for everyone. Why? Because when we don't feel safe, we want to make everyone in our lives through our lifetime to feel safe and protected. And that's why you're so caring and sometimes people pleaser, or you're taking too much responsibility. So why you chose this? The spirits are telling me that you're attracting somebody that is going to bring you light, color, music, joy. You want somebody that it's not bringing more drama, bringing more responsibilities. Not that you're not going to be there for him or her, for your future spouse, but what I sense very clearly is that you need a rest. You need a rest at last. You need to attract somebody, and it makes sense. Where did I read rest? Where is rest? Rest. Rest. I am listening as well from spirits. You need a sort of reset. I think that lately you have been feeling quite with your energy, quite low. And you have just started, maybe some of you weeks, months, even some of you 2 years, suddenly, because something happened in your life that, whoa, changed your chip in your mind, and everything started to change. You have realized that you have to take care of yourself. If you're not taking care of yourself, how can you manifest this incredible future spouse? And it makes sense. So rainbows is always success. This love story is going to be successful. No divorce, no separations, no drama. I don't think even that both of you guys are going to have not even one argument. And if it happens, it's just by talking and listening to one another. I don't see like he or she judging you, or you criticizing your future spouse. Both of you, your old souls, both of you have been healers, your natural healers. Whether you're a healer professionally or not, maybe you're, if whether you're therapist or coach, or maybe if it's not that, maybe you're responsible of a team, or maybe you're responsible of your own business, or maybe you're responsible of your kids, whatever situation you're passing through right now, both of you, you don't want to know drama. That's why the musical, you want somebody that it's going to bring an energy that it's lighter, that's going to make you feel that you can rest beside that person and you can be yourself. And it's fine if one day we don't go a partying, if it's fine if another day we don't go with those friends, because there's no obligation. Both of you, you're going to do whatever your body tells you you should do. You have just started to listen to your body. And I have to, before I continue, why the unleash is talking about blockages and sex here. Pleasure, unleash the wild within, she the wolf, whether you're a man or a woman. These two cards is telling me that your future spouse is going to unblock you sexually, energetically, sexually, probably the root chakra. Have you been having problems in your root chakra physically? Maybe if you're a woman, maybe with your, I hope I can talk about this in a natural way because something natural, but maybe you have problems with your menstruation or your ovaries, or maybe you wanted to get pregnant with a partner and you lost one baby at least, or, I mean, it was not a long process. I mean, maybe you felt, you knew you were pregnant and suddenly you lost it and it was traumatic for you. Or maybe you were abused, if not sexually, you passed through situations that made you feel very uncomfortable. Maybe sexual harassment, or maybe somebody that you felt the energy because you're a healer, you're very connected with energy, and you sense somebody if it's good for you or not, or toxic for you or not, if they're trespassing a line, they cannot fool you because you know. So this person, whatever situation you have passed through, maybe because you got really touched and very tired after that ex or ex-husband or ex-wife, some of you, maybe you have been married as well. This person, your future spouse, is going to bring you pleasure, light energy, and it's going to help you clean and release energy, sexual energy from other partners. This is very interesting. Your future spouse must be a very powerful healer, because I know that all of us, we can clean ourselves the sexual energy of past partners by patience, meditations, grounding ourselves. But I didn't know. So maybe that's one of his or her abilities, to clean the energy of others in you. To clean the sexual energy, to clean the blockages that is not allowing you to have pleasure even with yourself. Probably you have been feeling like very low sexually, not even wanted to give yourself pleasure or to relax. I hope it's okay I talk like this. I always talk with all of my love and respect. But sex is something, a part of a relationship, that it's very natural. So he or she's going to heal you sexually. Maybe you didn't have any sort of problem, but you're going to realize that with this person, you can have a lot of pleasure. But not only sexually. Both of you, you're going to have pleasure eating a nice sandwich, going on a nice walk and eating something, or just smelling the flowers. This, really guys, this future spouse that you're attracting, or maybe I'm talking about you, this is a confirmation that both of you guys, you're going to work on the same stuff. I think that both of you, you're very evolved, very, very, very evolved. You have been reincarnated in other planets, other galaxies, as well as on planet Earth. You have always come here like your future spouse because both of you, you wanted to return to planet Earth to help people to get out of that low vibration. You're attracting somebody that it's a great teacher. And this card always reminds me of Jesus Christ. Whenever I see this man, maybe he or she, if you want to meet a man, he looks like this one. Very beautiful, very beautiful, very Pleiadian, because I'm watching here a lot of yellow, the blonde hair. So I think that he or she's working with Pleiadians consciously or unconsciously. And maybe you too as well. YouTube, suddenly I was listening to YouTube. Maybe some of them, they're YouTubers. This person is bringing peacefulness and happiness and joy, and is showing the world how to co-create with the divine and God. Your future spouse is a great teacher for many to follow their spiritual experiences. I think that your future spouse is teaching a lot of people not to believe everything that is being told by everyone that it's famous concerning spiritual matters or not. That they have to trust their intuition and their faith. If this is serving me, I will take it. If this does not resonate, I will not take it. So your future spouse is teaching students, employers, subscribers, fans that they have to follow more what they feel, that everything is inside of them. And that's true. I am a healer too. And I teach in the very similar way to your future spouse. Or maybe you are working like this as well. If I'm watching the, the dream catcher, it means that both of you, you're connecting through your dreams and she's sleeping beside. So isn't this an incredible synchronicity? And both of you, you're going to become a star. I am listening. Both of you, you're very down to earth. Both of you, you want to create so much abundance, but you're never going to be shallow about it or to show off. You're going to use it for a good thing. Yes, you're going to help a lot of people through donations, societies. You're going to create projects in maybe in South America or in Africa or in other countries, even in your own country that right now, because of the virus, many people are passing through poverty. I didn't have even enough money to eat well. Both of you, you want to create abundance, to live in a calm way, to be able to rest when you can rest, to be able to take days off, and both of you travel some, for example, go to a beautiful cabin in the forest for a weekend. So for you, the way both of you guys, you see abundance is a way, is like a ticket for freedom and to move as you wish in this three dimension and to show the world that going through shadow work. And that's why the deep, dark sea mermaid, and this person is very deep, very deep, 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 very deep, okay, very, find solutions in the unknown places in the darkness. So your future spouse knows perfectly how to show people how to pass through shadow work, through the shadows, after a dark tower moment, after a really bad depression, after really... They know how to show the path, the light, but not telling them, you have to do this. Your future spouse says all of this, all of the possibilities that they have learned through the path. Sorry, guys, I'm moving so much. The hands are getting excited. Sorry, I am half Spanish. You can tell how I move my hands. Okay. So... They are going to show different solutions. That's why I find solutions, different solutions. And he is just going to tell the viewers, clients, people through the books, through the videos, through the website, through the services. Look, I think that this could help work for you, but I'm going to tell you five ways you can try the five and choose the one that you feel comfortable with. It's incredible that it comes out the moon. Angala, it's the meaning in Spanish, like success, like when you're working in Hollywood and imagine that you're creating a movie and they give you the, yes, like an Oscar. Gala is like an Oscar. So really, guys, both of you, you're going to become very successful. And the moon, it's Cancer. There's a lot of Cancer energy here. So probably I think that they're very, if not Cancer, they have a lot of water in the chart. But I think that they have fire as well, or maybe you have fire, air element I'm sensing as well. One of the two is very air element, okay? Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. Wow, this is amazing. I love it. He or she is a great teacher to show the world, to the world people that they are lost, or they feel lost, how they can, look, the deer. Recently I saw two deer, suddenly. It was amazing. Watching the two deers. And they know how to show people how to create a paradise for them. And being in paradise doesn't mean to be rich. Some people don't need a lot of money to be happy. And others, maybe some of you, you would love to have a lot of money. So you are able to get to more resources to help more people. What I see very clearly is that both of you, you're very focused in your sole purpose. And I think that both of you believe, although both of you are going to be so in love with each other, no problem at all in this marriage, okay? And no problem at all that both of you, you're from different cultures. Some of you, you're from different cultures, okay, guys? And I think that you're going to meet each other, or you're going to marry in 1 year and a half, the latest. 2 years, the latest. And I think that some of you, you're going to meet in 6 months, other 8 months, 9 months, and 11. That's showing me 11. So, beautiful connection, very innocent connection. Why the innocence? Because this person too is showing people how to heal their inner child. This is like the mom and the little unicorn. Take time to play, nurture your inner child, live with a childlike sense of wonder. So, this, your future spouse has healed his or her inner child. Is going to heal your inner child if you need it still. And it's going to allow you to set yourself free. To set yourself free in sex. To set yourself free outside sex. To be yourself. They're going to encourage you to always say what you need and what you feel. And to have a playfulness, a playful energy. This came out a lot in group number one. Be playful, playfulness. So both of you, you're going to feel like two little kids sometimes when you want to have fun. You're going to make jokes like two little kids. Maybe you're in the kitchen and you cannot listen to him or her, and they approach you at the back. And you know those type of games from little kids? I see a lot of games and like innocent jokes. I don't sense like a dark humor or a sarcastic humor. No, I sense more like an innocence. Humor. But I have to tell you, this person is going to surprise you in sex. I mean, if they didn't want to become a healer, they would, sorry to say this, but I say it. They would have been a great porno star. Oh my gosh, what am I saying? That is true, that's what I see. And why the wolf element, the animal totem of the wolf, and I didn't say it, sorry, the spirits are reminding me, thank you, spirits. Your future spouse is somebody, it's a free soul. Free soul. If you told your future spouse, I don't want you to be a healer, I don't want you to do that, they wouldn't continue the relationship. And I don't want you to get upset about this. It's not going to happen, because I believe that all of you guys, if both of you, you are like the same, if you're not a healer, but you're working on something different, or you're an artist, a creative, and maybe you're into music, maybe some of them, they are healing through the music. Maybe they're singers as well. Maybe they are music producers. And they are mixing music with spirituality, with a soul purpose, touch hearts, to heal through the music, okay? I didn't say it before. Maybe they're into classical music. Or they're into rock music, and they're going to tell you that the base of rock music, it's Mozart and classical music. And that's true. So this person is not going to live their sole purpose. And I think that if you're going to attract this incredible future spouse, it's because you would never lose your passion or your creativity for somebody else. Because that's not love. That's controlling. That's fear. And he or she does not operate from fear like you neither. Maybe you have been working a lot through fear, through your fears. Maybe I think that many of you, you're still... You're still recovering yourself from a lot of pain. That's why the two dogs, which this is a meaning as well, that both of you guys are going to be faithful and loyal to each other. And I think that the feminine energy is going to be healed by the two of you. Both of you, you had to heal the energy of the female energy. Female energy, it's emotions. Maybe you had problems with your mom, or maybe he or she had problems with their mom. But this person is going to heal you, heal your wounds from the past. And I think that some of you, as I was going to say, you're still releasing negativity from past experiences, not only from romantic experiences, but I sense from even friends that you felt betrayed, or family that was supposed to be there, but it's like you feel like they're putting you down, your self-esteem. They're not helping you to raise your vibration or your self-esteem. But remember, they're not, I mean, they're doing what they're supposed to do, and you're doing what you're supposed to do. You're living in a human experience like your future spouse. And for sure, they have long hair. A little bit long hair at least, and some of them very long hair. And if you want to meet a woman, I believe that she's not blonde, Hazel. Well, some could be the hair like this one, a little bit short and very dark. Okay, even a little bit black and blue with a mermaid. I see a lot of sensuality and pleasure. I see light. I think that both of you guys, you're going to make love in an energetical way, in a very sensual way. Not so much like too sexual and too dominant. No, it seems like more sensuality, and you're going even to manifest, both of you guys, when you're going to make love, you're going to manifest through that energy. Wow, interesting. I think that one of the two is already very famous, or both of you, you're going to become celebrities in the spiritual realm, or maybe in the business field. It could be as well, and spirituality is inside of both of you, and that's why you're doing so much good. Both of you have a great heart, and you want to do a lot of good. And patience, why is that? Because the spirits are telling you that your future spouse is having patience to meet you, because they know it's going to be the correct timing. They're very aware of that, and I think that you too. Sometimes you get a little bit impatient, but you know that it's worth it. And why this is the last card? Write a gratitude list. Spirits are telling you a way for you to connect with your future spouse sooner, write a gratitude list. And this is true. And your future spouse is somebody that feels gratitude. And I think that you too as well. That's why both of you, the more you feel gratitude, the sooner you will find each other, and it's going to be like magical. Wow, group number three. I want to shuffle the last one, an image. I didn't do this in the other groups, but I feel the spirits are telling me to get these ones. Wow, look at that. Beautiful connection. Nature is going to be an important part for both of you. I think that both of you, you need to have one or several houses, at least with a garden in the forest or forest nearby or the sea. But it's beautiful. I see both of you being able to be vulnerable in front of each other and not being afraid of even talking about secrets or stuff that you have been feeling guilty about. And really, everything is going to be healed just being together. Oh my gosh, I love it. Wow. I'm impressed by spirits. Let me know in the comments, group number three. If you really want to support me, you know, guys, through donations for the channel. And if it's not through donation, supporting me, giving me a like, subscribing, leaving me a comment would be amazing. If you even subscribe in my Instagram channel with the same name, more amazing, even more. And I sense this relationship is going to grow to more love. And both of you guys, you're going to expand. Your love is going to expand, and your soul work, your soul journey is going to expand together. Expand. Beautiful. I love all of you guys. You deserve this. You're amazing. My lovelies. Bye. You say take me on a treasure hunt. I long for something new. Have you heard the fairies when they sing and dance? Oh, I wish it was me. Welcome, group number four. Wow. Wow, guys, you have passed through a lot, or you're passing through a lot, or you tend to complicate stuff because you learned it from your parents. I have to be very sincere, okay, guys? I'm not telling you, oh, you're a complicated person, or but spirits wants you to be aware. I'm starting, normally I start about talking about the future spouse in, I have just done it with the rest of the groups, but the spirits are telling me that I have to start talking about all of you guys. Remember, if you don't resonate with these messages, choose another group. But what I see very clearly with Break the Chain, ancestral patterns, healing, rewriting the future, and a baby, which could mean babies because you want to create a family with your future spouse, or this is a project that you have in your mind, being with your future spouse, for you is very important, is your priority. But spirits are telling you, there's something, the engaño in Spanish, it's like betrayal, no? Like something that is wearing mask and it's an illusion, it's not a reality. And this is reconciliation with somebody that's coming from the past. So what I'm sensing, group number four, very clearly, I sense the spirits were telling me like different type of stories because it's many of you. Some of you, you just cannot forget about your ex. And I tell you guys, if it's not a karmic relationship, if they didn't unrespect you, but it didn't work out because neither or both were prepared, or maybe one of the two, you were not prepared, or maybe you show that he or she is your twin flame, but it was not back then, the time. This could be a yes for some of you. Okay, for others, I see this very clearly with the singer, with expansion. And these cards. Okay, some of you, you have a celebrity in your mind. You have a celebrity in your mind because you have been receiving messages, probably through different readers, different readings, even private readings that you have paid. I'm not telling you this is for everyone, but for many of you that you don't know personally, you haven't spoken with a particular person, whether a celebrity or not, and you're so sure, or at least that's what you think. You think this is somebody that you have been liking and it's coming from the past. This is not somebody new. This is somebody that you have been liking for quite a long time, or just recently, and then suddenly, whoa, this is my twin flame. He or she is going to be my future spouse. Could be a celebrity, a singer, maybe an actor, an actress, or somebody that it's doing very good economically, or maybe somebody that you admire because he's a writer or works in the NASA. But whoever you have in your mind, but I sense more, this message is for the ones that it's somebody that you follow on Instagram or in social media, or it's somebody famous, and you think for sure that he or she is the one for you. Spirits are telling you that this is part of your soul lesson, to discern between illusion and reality, to expand your mind, to expand yourself, expand your soul. If a story like this one is in your mind and 1 month has passed, 2, 3, 1 year, 2 years, and nothing passes, nothing is manifested, then you have to be aware that that's a lie, that ego or fear or something that it's coming from your parents, ancestral parents. Maybe you are releasing and cleaning and healing an obsessive or very focused love on in someone that was not meant to be with the other person. Maybe your grandmother passed through that and you are here to release that, and that's why you're living it. Let me know in the comments if it makes sense, guys. Some of you, do you believe and that you have found your twin flame and you have not even talked with that person, or maybe you have crossed some words, but they don't even know who you are? Then open your eyes. Stop lying to yourself. Be careful. That's ego, and that's you cleaning and healing and rewriting the future. When you change and settle ancestral patterns, when you heal, when you see everything with a wider perspective, that's why the ego is the representation of USA as well for me. Okay, guys, trust in the unknown. One of your guides and your master is telling you, which is a male figure, maybe it could be a father or grandfather for some of you, get out of that story. Get out of there. Because this is just delaying you to find the one, which is the emperor, which is the ideal partnership for you. And both of you, you're supposed to marry each other. That's why the high priestess, whether you're going to be connected more to the truth, to your soul, to the reality, to the true reality, not the 3D dimension reality, but the reality of who you are. You're somebody that you're here to celebrate yourself, to be happy with yourself, to expand your soul, to expand your ideas, your world, remember? If nothing is happening out of that story, maybe some of you, it's somebody, it's an ex that you cannot leave it. And spirits are telling you, come on, expand, leave it, overcome it. You are delaying stuff. You're delaying somebody new. And again, I tell you guys, some of you, yes, this is a confirmation of somebody from the past that maybe both of you guys, you merely went out together, or it's an ex, that suddenly, even an ex-husband, ex-wife, could be that suddenly time passes, both of you, you evolve, both of you, you expand, both of you, you know yourself better, and you find each other in the perfect timing, it could be as well. This is a general reading, I always say that. Listen to your heart, listen to your experience, and maybe you're going to receive hints through this reading that it's going to say, whoa, yes. So the person that you are attracting, it's somebody that was very close to his or her grandfather. Okay, because I see like a sort of a grandfather. And this is somebody that it's, I think that one of the two is very spiritual and the other one is not so spiritual. So if you're very spiritual, they're not very spiritual, but they're very good people. Both of you, you're very good people, but one of the two is more spiritual than the other. I think that both of you had to find each other. So the one that it's more spiritual is going to make the other one expand, concerning spirituality. And if the baby comes out, it's because this is a representation of family growing or your first child with this person, or maybe this person has already a kid, or maybe you already have a kid. As well, this is the meaning, babies, and I said this in my Spanish reading a few days ago, it's the meaning of a project. Both of you, probably you're going to work in the same project, or maybe both of you, you know each other in the same company, in the same job. Maybe you have just been hired in a new company, in a new job, and you're going to meet both of you there. I don't sense that neither of the two you have your own business yet. Because if the ideal partnership comes out, it's because both of you are going to be together. Celebration, High Priestess for me, absolutely is marriage, is commitment, no problem at all. And two holes, which is the all, is the animal totem of psychics, of clairvoyance, psychics, a lot of intuition I see. At least one of the two is very, very, very intuitive. And just by being together, it's going to make the other one expand their abilities, the psychic abilities. Okay, and I think that both of you, and one of the two, or maybe you're a tarotist, or maybe he or she's a tarotist, or you love tarot, or you would love to be professional in tarot, okay? It could be because it's besides the Ace of Pentacles. If some of you, you're already doing some stuff about this, you're doing the same in YouTube, or you're thinking about it, spirits are telling you that you would create a lot of abundance through tarot, or through something that it's close by to tarot. Maybe it's working with stones, or maybe it's hypnotherapy, maybe it's something different. Master of Reiki, energy, but more than energy, which absolutely both of you, you're going to work always through energy like everyone does, whether you're aware or not. I see like something more like, yes, like tarot, reading the palm of the hands, runes, maybe predictions through runes, predictions through coffee, like they do in South America. Or through dreams, maybe you would be amazing as astrology, I'm listening as well. If it's not you, then it's the other person. I see expansion. Expansion course in a business related to tarot, runes, astrology, or something like that. Because I see a lot of books at the back. So spirits are telling you, whether it's you or maybe it's the other person, you are going to prepare yourself. You're going to read a lot of stuff. You're going to do courses to learn more so you can teach others more elements. And I think that you're going to add different kind of elements concerning tarot. You're going to teach another way of doing tarot. And this is, I totally relate with this idea because that's what I'm going to do very soon with my courses. So spread your wings and soar. Get out of that. I think that some of you, you're going out with somebody that it's not showing their true selves to you. Or maybe you are not being faithful to the one that you're going out with right now and you still you want to be married. Be aware, everything is energy. If you're not being clear and if you're not playing from love but you're playing from ego and fear, then the result will be this, a toxic result. But if you're being true to yourself and to the people around you, you will attract more truth to your soul and more opportunities. This person is going to love to communicate with you through calm. I see a lot talking each other through calm. I even think that both of you don't live in the same city. Oh, you didn't live in the same city, because I told you guys, no, that some of you are going to meet through work, or maybe you're going to pay one of his or her courses and you're going to meet there. Maybe you're going to be one. It's something concerning a job, a career, courses online, or maybe both of you, you're going to meet a community, a spiritual community, a spiritual retreat that I am listening as well. Or maybe both of you, you're going to try wine in a celebration, or maybe there's a wedding. He's proposing. The wine is proposing to the cheese. This is so funny, I say this. Are you the cheese? Do you love cheese? Maybe he or she loves wine. Maybe you love the wine from Spain, which is very good. Or you love the wine from Italy. On Greece, I know in California they make really good wine. Maybe some of you, you're from California, you're going to end up in USA. That's why the eagle. The eagle is always the animal totem of getting a wider perspective of your life. Spirits are telling you that if you want to do something with somebody that it's in your mind, or you do it, or you close doors. You return with that ex that you don't forget, or you close doors and you begin something new. It's up to you. Loving yourself first, you make yourself being more respected. What's loving yourself? Loving yourself is taking care of your mind, of your emotions, of your habits. Are you eating well? Are you saying no to stuff that you don't like, or that you're going to lose money, but you're going to win great energy and wisdom, and you're going to be more prepared in the future to make more money? Be wise, I am listening from spirits. Make up your mind. Group number four, I think that you have to make up your mind to create, to attract this incredible emperor. If you want to meet a woman, an empress, one of the two is very powerful concerning their intuition, very clairvoyance. Maybe some of you can smell or see orbits, or you can smell spirits, or you have premonitions. And if it's not you, it's the other person. With the Ace of Pentacles, it means this is a new beginning. So if you want to return with an ex, or if you have somebody in your mind and time passes and nothing is going on, or you do something about it, or you close doors and you open and you leave the universe space to bring you this new person. But it's up to you. If you want to return with an ex and you feel happy, go for it. Then it's your destiny, because this is a general reading. Break the chain, the toxic chain. Break the toxic chain of people that are not good for you, or thoughts that are not realistic. And that's true. I don't remember the name of this. I follow this guy that it's a YouTuber, and he's very good at advising women how to attract men and how to overcome. And he was doing this talk, and suddenly one of the women, I said that I have to tell you guys this example, because it could be a message, an important message for some of you, or a confirmation. This woman was complaining that this guy was, I mean, she was crying, like he didn't want to commit, or he was not giving her what she wanted, or he was not being clear. I think that the guy was not texting her or answering her texts sometimes. And he was very clear. And he asked her, is he giving you what you want? Is he making you happy? And she said, no. Then he said, then why are you still in this story? Why are you still in this chain? Break it. Why? Remember, guys, because sometimes when a grandmother, or grandfather, or an ancestor have passed through betrayal or through very toxic relationships, or was obsessed because it was a karmic relationship. Remember, guys, when we have that sort of obsession or focus of energy, very intense, and we think this is the one, probably it's a karmic relationship. That's why you feel it like that. And we think it's the one, and it's the contrary. It's fake. It's not real. It's not real love. But it's part of the journey of the soul to learn. So ask yourself, if you're still in a story, or it's difficult for you to forgive an ex or exes, think about it. Why do you think is that?
Did your mom pass through the same? Did your grandmother or your grandfather or your dad? Remember how you have been taught about love? You're repeating the same stuff. And when you get out your mask and you be true to yourself, boom, you break the change. You clean the karma of your family by allowing yourself to fly like that eagle, to expand and to celebrate yourself. When you're going to be able to be happy with yourself, being alone, this person is going to appear like boom, like magic. And everything is going to go very quickly. I sense that both of you guys, you're going to marry in less than 1 year. Even in weeks, some of you, you're going to marry. Probably this person has a lot of fire in the chart. Or maybe you have a lot of fire. Spirits are telling me that enough of being so impulsive and like balance the way you react and think and sense. I think that most of you guys doing yoga or running through nature or just walking with nice affirmations through nature would help you balance. Because I sense all of you guys, you're so powerful. But you have to love yourself. And remember, loving yourself is going to nature, grounding yourself, is eating healthily, is not getting stuck in a toxic story that is not evolving and expanding. You need to expand. And if it's not expanded, leave it. If somebody tells you, I love you, but they're not there, leave. If you're struggling with someone, is not reacting, is not giving you what you want, leave. Leave. It's very simple. Love is simple. Don't listen so much. Some people are very good with the words. Watch actions. How are they acting? Are they giving you? Or they're being selfish? Are they just being there because they're bored or because you are the third person they're going to see in during the week? And if it's you that you're doing this, how can you expect an incredible love story, a future spouse, if you're not giving respect to yourself? Not because you are going out with several people, some of you. No, that's fine. As long as you don't hurt anyone and you're sincere. But honor your heart. Honor yourself. Expand through the loving energy, but within yourself. Because it's incredible what's going ahead for you. Group number four. It's just amazing. Let me shuffle this one. That time to get this one before I end up the reading. Doesn't make sense, guys. Not the time to get this one. Eight of Wands. You're stuck in a story, whether you're conscious or unconscious, that it's not allowing you to set yourself free. And it's only making you suffer. So leave it. Leave it. Leave anything that it's not allowing you to flow from love. That's why I meant to get this one. Eight of Pentacles. That's great. 8-8. That's amazing. Very beautiful connection of soulmates coming on your way. And twin flames, some of you. So my loves, you are living this energy. Let's embrace the Eight of Pentacles. Abundance. Stability. Knowing how to be alone. Sensing love within yourself. That's your key, group number four. Sensing love within yourself and stopping any kind of bullshit, toxic situations. Leave it. You don't deserve that. And others, maybe you're on the other side and you're not, maybe somebody's in love with you and you're playing a little bit with them. Be aware. Yes? Group number four. I hope it makes sense, because the amazing love relationship, marriage, celebration, maybe through a wedding, maybe through a birthday, maybe through a party. Yes? Both of you guys, you could meet. Beautiful communication between both of you guys. Ideal partnership. He or she's going to propose, or you're going to propose in less than 1 year. And one of the two, it's going to really expand the business. I think if it's not YouTube, in a online platform concerning tarot, psychic, or runes, or something, or maybe you want to prepare online courses, and that's why you see so many books. So whatever it is, if it's not there, it's something else, go for it. Come on, my love. Some of you, you're going to become famous singers. I love you, group number four. Come on, you're doing amazing. If you want to support my channel through donations, would be amazing. If it's not through donations, subscribing, giving a like, leaving a comment, even subscribing in my Instagram account with the same name, Anna Robertson Angels Whisper. I love all of you so much. Come on. Bye, my angels.
You say, take me on a treasure hunt. I long for something new. Have you heard the fairies when they sing and dance?